He's known only as Skeleton 22, found buried in Durham 4 years ago. He's a Scottish soldier who was imprisoned and died in the city following the Civil War Battle of Dunbar in 1650. Discovered with the remains of other bodies, extensive research has been continuing into the finds. And that brings us to here. At Face Lab at Liverpool John Moores University, they specialise in reconstructing faces for archaeological and forensic purposes. Here, they've created a digital reconstruction of the skull of Skeleton 22. It's being described as a poignant opportunity to come face to face with a young man who lived and died more than 300 years ago.
When we have the whole skull and we have access to the original specimen, then we can follow an anatomical process for predicting facial features and for modelling the anatomical structures, mostly the musculature, directly onto the skull. And we use a 3D digital system for building the face through the muscle structure through to the finished skin layer, and then we can use CGI techniques for adding the skin textures and the hair and the clothing, etc.
This box of tricks here ensure the team don't have to bring human skulls and human remains back to Liverpool. This device can be taken out into the field and will scan a skull, store the information digitally, and it's that information that can be downloaded onto the PCs here. And that, of course, is where the hard work begins.
This is what the skull looked like when it was scanned into the computer. It's the start of a complex procedure that needs powerful software, skilled operators, and can take a long time to complete.
And we can start adding on realistic facial textures, so moles, wrinkles, including the scar on his forehead, because we know that from the bone, we can place that directly onto the skin and build it up as if to look like a realistic scar as well.
Skeleton 22 now has a face. No one claims he looked exactly like this, but this is his most likely appearance, based on archaeological, historical and physiological evidence to determine things like hairstyle and skin texture. FaceLab has already recreated the faces of historical figures, including Robert the Bruce and Richard III. Where does the technology go from here? Well, they're already working on animating the reconstructions and adding voices. One day, we'll not only be able to look at these images, but hear them talking as well. Ralph Blunsom, ITV News, at Liverpool John Moores University.